Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Start by gathering all the components and pulling them through the opening in the front panel. Then we need to reattach the radio cables, the wire that goes to the meter, and the ventilation tubes. After that, we can start fastening the screws and putting the panel back in place. Then start attaching the components back onto the handlebar. Next up is the panel underneath the handlebar and on top of the ignition. Continue fastening the screws around the panel. Then attach the handlebar covers. Next up, put back the panel underneath the windscreen wiper and install the windscreen wiper as well. and that's how you reassemble the front end. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Put the floor in place and fasten all the screws. Then install the cover on top of the chair frame. Then put the back panels in place. Next, attach the seat belt. Then put the back seat back. And finally, put the driver's seat back in place. Remember to connect the sensor wire underneath it. There you go, all done. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Then remove the back seat. Unscrew the bar that holds the batteries in place. Then unscrew the battery cables. Remove the lids from the batteries underneath and put them back into place. Remove the heat sensor. The battery warmer set consists of three parts. The isolator goes on the bottom. Install the warmer this side down. Then put the net on top. The net distributes the weight of the batteries evenly. Then put the batteries back in place. Put the thermostat back. And fasten the holder. Then connect the battery cables. You will also need to do some small alterations to the back seat. Remove these bits shown on the video. And there you go. Just install the back seat and you're done. Here you see the front brake and how it connects with the caliper. This is the back brake. And here we're gonna follow the lines all the way back. Underneath the floor to the handbrake, and from there to the right side and to the left side, and here we see it from behind how it connects to the calipers. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Here you can see the wiring harness, how it goes from the front all the way to the back. When changing the wiring harness, start by putting it in place. And when the front end is in place, start connecting the wires one by one. When all the wires are connected to the new wiring harness, remove the old one. Connect the handbrake. And continue to pull out the old wiring harness. Then pull the new harness under the floor towards the back. Continue putting the harness into place. Pull out all the wires so you can see clearly what you need to connect. If you want to, you can cut the old harness. This makes it easier to work with it. Then start connecting the wires to the new harness. There you go. Now it's done. Before you start putting everything back together, it's important that you test that everything works properly. We're gonna start with the reverse camera and the throttle. Then test the horn and the lights. Front. And back. Test high beam and low beam. Then test the turning lights. Back. And front. Make sure that the radio works. As well as the windscreen wiper and the spray, the fan and the heater, test the brakes and the braking lights, test the dead switch. Now that we know that everything works, tidy up the cables in the back so that the back seat fits on top of them. In this video, we're going to change the whole rear differential, and we're also going to install a new motor. Start by lifting the differential in place. Then attach the differential to the frame. Next, we're going to put the brake caliper in place. You might need to pry it open a little bit so that it will fit on top of the disc. Then do the same thing on the other side. Next thing we're gonna do is attach the brake cables to the differential. Then fasten the shocks. Then we're going to install the engine. Start by cleaning the surfaces properly. Here you can use a seal. Or then you can use silicone. Then continue with installing the motor. Here you can see all the screws that hold the motor in place. And here you can see how the cables from the motors goes up towards the controller. The next step is to connect all the wires. Start by removing the back seat. Next, you need to locate the bigger of the two small yellow boxes and open it up. Unscrew these power cables. Disconnect the cable going to the controller. After that, pull the cables out. Then push the cables from the new motor through and pull them up. Attach the wires so that they don't fall down, and then connect them. Then put away the cables and put the back seat back, and you're done. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Then start removing the panels. There are a lot of screws, but just follow the example in the video. Don't forget to detach the battery charge indicator. To remove the charger, unscrew the screw and disconnect the cables. Open up the small yellow box and unscrew the cables. There you go, you have successfully removed the charger. To install the charger, just reverse these steps. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Remove the windscreen wiper and the panel underneath it. From here you can access the lights. In the middle you have the headlight, and by removing this cover you can access the bulb. On this video we're going to show you how the reverse camera is connected. We're going to start from the back and follow it all the way to the front. From the back, it comes up here, and then splits so that it goes to the controller. The cable goes to the front first under the floor and then behind the front panel. Here Here you see how the screen is mounted on the dashboard. And here you see how you connect the screen. And how you attach it. For this, you can use an adhesive or just a two-sided tape. Be sure that the handlebar does not hit the screen when you turn. In this video, we're going to show you how to use the radio in the GoMoto 3.3. To turn on the radio, press this button here in the upper left corner. Use the mod button to choose between radio or Bluetooth. When in radio, use these two buttons, forward and backwards, to choose the tuning and search for the station. If you press and hold, it will automatically search for the nearest station. If you press just once, you will manually be able to choose the tuning. On the right side, the buttons V plus and V minus control the volume. When Bluetooth mode is selected, open the Bluetooth settings from your telephone and connect it to the radio. Once the connection is complete, the word blue will stop blinking. Here you can also find a slot for a memory card, and the USB port is for charging your mobile phone. To turn off the radio, simply hold the power button again. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. To remove the handlebar cover, unscrew the screws shown on the video. Then remove the ring around the ignition lock. After that, unscrew these four screws. Then pry open the panel using a screwdriver or something similar. Now you should be able to change the lock. The lock is fastened with one cable and two screws. Unscrew these screws and disconnect the cable in order to change the lock. To change the lock in the door, start by removing this panel. Here you see the locking mechanism. This wire is supposed to be a little bit loose. From here, it's easy to change the locking mechanism. Just unscrew the old one and insert the new one. Start by turning off the fuse. Then turn the key in the ignition to make sure that there is no more charge left in the system. Then start removing the panels. There are a lot of screws, but just follow the example in the video. Don't forget to detach the battery charge indicator. To remove the seat, unscrew these four screws. Remember to detach the sensor wire. To remove the floor, follow these steps. To remove the handlebar cover, unscrew the screws shown on the video. Then remove the ring around the ignition lock. After that, unscrew these four screws. Then pry open the panel using a screwdriver or something similar and disconnect the wires. Then remove the handlebar together with all the components attached to it. Next, remove the front panel. Here again, there are a lot of screws, but just follow the example. Before we can remove the front panel, there are a few things we need to do. First, disconnect the radio. And then we need to disconnect the ventilation tubes. This is easier to do if you remove the panel underneath the windscreen wiper. Cut the tube leading to the sprayer and remove the tube leading to the windscreen fluid reservoir. Now you will be able to access these tubes easily. After this, we're ready to remove the front panel. Here you can also see the cables leading to the radio and to the meter. To remove the meter, you will need to unscrew it from the backside. Same thing goes with the radio. It needs to be removed from the backside.